The automotive industry is a cradle of innovation and creativity, and that is how cars have managed to evolve so much in only like 130 years. There are churches in Europe that took 300 years to be built. But here's the thing, not all inventions are good, and not all good inventions end up getting made. In this episode, we're gonna talk about 10 failed car inventions and also talk about some of the great ideas which never made it to market. So expect to hear about a car that can make coffee, suspension made by a stereo company, and even a freaking horse head. Get your number two pencils all sharp, cause there will be a Scantron test at the end. This is
D-List. Number 10. Fiat 500L espresso machine.
In 2013, the Fiat 500L, I think L probably stands for latte, was the first car, surprisingly, to be offered with its own coffee maker, besides the Trans Am that Exhibit pimped out in 2004. I always say Edison, Tesla, Exhibit. This optional $300 coffee experience package meant that between the front and back seats in the space you'd usually find a cup holder sat a legit espresso maker. It had its own power supply and it would brew you up an espresso in a matter of minutes. Now, I am a former barista. My foam art game is top level. And I think this is a terrible idea. Boiling water in a moving vehicle, and easy access to mind-altering levels of caffeine. What could possibly go wrong? Unsurprisingly, it didn't sell all that well. And in fact, it didn't sell over here in the US at all. You know, maybe Fiat was scared because Americans sue people. We got lawyers. And them lawyers would be hungry for a nice, I burnt myself on my espresso machine and crashed into this kindergarten case. Built-in espresso machine, less coffee stops, more bathroom stops, which brings me on to this.
Number 9, Cadillac in-car toilet.
This one's awesome. This is not a joke at all. Cadillac actually invented a car with a built-in toilet. It was designed to help them complete a 10,000-mile continuous drive as part of a publicity stunt that they were planning. But after that success, Cadillac actually considered fitting it to production cars, and they weren't alone. Rolls-Royce also played with toilet technology in the early 1950s. Kids, do not play with toilet technology. Toilet technology is a tool, not a toy. The 1954 Rolls-Royce Vignale was a one-of-one commissioned by a guy from New York, Joseph Mashush. It was a rebodied, long-base silver Wraith. Mashush ordered many bespoke features. The engine block, cylinder head, and carburetor were all painted in forest green. The valve covers were chromed, and there was a toilet built into the back seat. Now, obviously, this wasn't ever gonna become a feature on production cars because there were too many issues with the plumbing. But in 1954, Rolls-Royce's solution was to just have the doo-doo and pee-pee fall onto the road under the car. Classy, Rolls-Royce. Very classy. The average person spends between 6 and 8 hours a day online. That's a lot. It's important to make sure that you're surfing securely. Surfshark VPN is an easy-to-use solution to all of the problems surrounding the giving and receiving of information online. That'll keep you safe from fraud and ID theft. And browsing anonymously will mean that your search history remains yours and out of the hands of evil corporations. Plus, there's all the fun stuff too. You can shop anonymously and get better prices, as well as being able to access international streaming services and watch better movies and TV shows from Japan. Surfshark is totally unlimited and can be used on as many devices as you like at the same time. No other VPN allows this. With 24/7 live customer support and a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee, these guys actually really have your back. Enter promo code Donut Media for 85% off and an extra 3 months
for free.
Go to surfshark.deals/donutmedia to find out more information. Support the companies that support Donut. That's how we get to make these videos for free.
Number 8, Mercedes Air Balance Package.
The Mercedes S-Class is the vehicle from which the rest of the automotive world takes inspiration. And over the years, so much tech has been seen for the first time on the S-Class. I'm talking air suspension, ventilated seat, seatbelt pretensioners, keyless entry and ignition, radar-guided cruise control, just to name a lot. But one S-Class advancement, which was a step too far, was the Mercedes Air Balance Package. I know it sounds like a collab between New Balance and Nike, but it's not. It was basically a bottle of perfume hidden in the glove compartment that would circulate through the car's air supply and keep the car smelling fresh forever. The problem? Oh, sounds great. Couldn't possibly see a problem. Well, the problem is, turns out, tons of people all over the world are allergic to the ingredients that make up most perfumes. And so, despite offering that fresh new car smell forever, the Mercedes Air Balance Package gave people rashes and respiratory problems. And it's a shame, because how many times have you been on a road trip with your dad and he's just pounding McDonald's breakfast burritos, just farting, farting. And you want to roll down your window, but it's the middle of winter and you're in West Virginia and it's 32 degrees outside. And you just wish that you had a button that you could press to make all those dad farts go away.
Number 7, Bose Magnetic Ride.
Bose, yeah, the speaker guys had an idea, which in my opinion was totally awesome. Now, the idea was to use magnets to adjust the car suspension in only a few thousandths of a second after it sensed a bump in the road, and in doing so, kept the car completely flat no matter what terrain you were driving on. Active suspension nowadays is fairly common, but 15 years ago, it was a novelty. Bose went and took it to another level altogether. The result of the Bose system was a super smooth ride and one of the most soothing video clips ever to be introduced into the world. I mean, look at this. It doesn't even look real. But it was too heavy and far too expensive to be offered in a standard road car. But the idea has been sold to another manufacturer who's attempting to work out the kinks, and I hope they do because it sounds freaking awesome and I want more of these super soothing clips of just all kinds of cars.
Number 6, onboard record player.
Our good friends over at Chrysler pioneered this bad boy, offering an alternative to the crackle of an AM radio with this, the in-car phonograph. Hey kid, put on your records. Ooh, you like them wax pressings? This was a real thing, not just a concept. They actually produced it in many of their popular 1950s cars. But it wasn't without its downsides, as you can imagine. Record players need to be completely static to work. The slightest movement will cause the needle to skip, or worse than that, scratch the vinyl, damaging it forever. And supposedly, it was near impossible to change the record from side A to side B without having a head-on collision. I can imagine. Beyond that, the needle was prone to skipping whenever the car went over a bump, which on 1950s roads was every 2 seconds. The needle had to be spring-loaded to make good contact with the record. This resulted in records being absolutely destroyed after 2 to 3 plays. Oh man, I would be so disappointed if my super rare original pressing of Dude Ranch got ruined while I was driving in my 50s Chrysler. Nolan's actually about to pick up a 1950s Chrysler Imperial in the next couple weeks. He's gonna park it at my house and work on it. So hopefully that one has a record player, or maybe I can source him one so he can just bump Deftones on vinyl as he drives through the hood.
Number 5, child partition.
Being stuck driving a car for hours and hours with kids or people you don't like can be a total drag. I mean, we've all been there. So would it shock you if I told you that the answer was actually invented in 1940, many auto manufacturers experimented with sliding partition tech at that time. It was thought that a limousine-style screen between parents and children would lighten the burden on the driver so they could focus on driving. The limousine screen itself dates back even further to the days of the horse and buggy. Back then, the occupants would sit in sumptuous velvet-coated quilted luxury while the driver sat on a wooden bench outside.
The sliding partition really never took off in everyday passenger vehicles, mostly due to the concern for the safety of unsupervised and inaccessible children. I would have loved to have a partition when I was a kid, not to keep me from them, but to keep them from me.
Number 4, horse head.
This one sounds terrifying. While we're on the subject of horse-drawn carriages, allow me to introduce to you the most abstract invention on this list. Okay, now when cars first started, you might not know this if you were born less than 100 years ago, it was a really scary thing for people. I mean, cars don't have souls. They don't have eyes. That's a thing that people used to say. I mean, my car doesn't have eyes, man. Like, your horse theoretically would keep you from driving it off of a cliff. And it wasn't just the people who had a problem with cars. It was horses, too. Horses had a rough time sharing the roads with these new gas machines. The solution to stop the horses from getting spooked was simple. They would put a life-sized horse's head made of wood on the front of a car. Unsurprisingly, it didn't stop horses from getting spooked. The thing didn't work. But as we know, gradually horses were replaced on the roads by cars, and the problem sort of worked itself out. Turns out the problem wasn't the cars, it was the horses. So we got rid of the horses. However, the days of spooked horses are over, because nowadays horses are if you like buff horses as much as I do, go to donutmedia.com and get yourself a new buff horses t-shirt. This is my favorite thing that we've ever made. But if horses are too buff for you, maybe try the less buff version of a horse, i.e. a dog. And if you want to take your dog on the road with you without getting a bunch of hair all over your interior, I got a product for you.
Number 3. Dog sex.
If you're anything like me, you love your car and you love your dog, but you can't stand getting hair, fleas, slobber, bits of food all over your clean car seats. The solution? Dog sacks. It was basically a canvas sack with a hole for your dog's head and hooks at the top that you would hook over your open window, and your dog would just fly on the side of your car. How insane is that? Now, I don't think it's that bad of an idea, honestly, especially if you have a dog and you don't have an SUV or a hatchback. I mean, people carry really small dogs around in freaking backpacks and handbags all the time in Beverly Hills, so what's the difference in this? Tell me in the comments.
Number 2, disappearing doors.
Now, this is another one that I wish would have been more successful. The incredible disappearing doors as seen on the BMW Z1. In a world where Gullwing, Scissor, Lambo, even suicide doors are a feature on several different models, the fact that disappearing doors aren't, that's a crying shame. That's crying shame. Check out how cool these freaking things are. I could watch that all day. The system works using a series of motors and belts, which is needlessly complicated and very, very heavy, but that doesn't stop it from looking totally freaking awesome. BMW didn't actually pioneer this technology. That accolade goes to Kaiser Darren Motor Company and their KF-161, which launched in 1953, and it had doors that rolled forward into the bodywork using rollers.
Number 1, the fifth wheel.
You ever been on a date with two couples, and you're not a couple, but you're friends with all four of them, and they just start kissing, you ain't got no one to kiss? That's called being a fifth wheel. But that's not the fifth wheel I'm talking about today. Parallel parking has always been one of the hardest skills for average drivers to master. I mean, I'm really, 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 really good at it, but not everybody is, and that's okay. You gotta reverse, you gotta steer, you gotta try not to scratch your car, you gotta try not to curb your wheels, you gotta try not to hit two other cars. That's hard. And parallel parking has led to a ton of different innovations trying to tackle it. I'm talking curb feelers, which are cool. Those big matte things that go on people's bumpers to protect them in the cities, which I think are not cool. Makes your car look like you're wearing a diaper. They have cars now which just parallel park themselves, which I think is trippy. So what did people do before? It may surprise you to know that way back in 1951, the retracting fifth wheel was the solution to all your parallel parking needs. It would drop down and allow you to steer the rear of your car directly into the space. Problem solved, right? Wrong. Okay, wrong. It
didn't solve the problem. The thing was heavy, it was impractical, and really, really hard to design a car around it. And it was prone to dropping down during normal driving, destroying itself, or not deploying at all when you were parallel parking and you actually needed it. Turns out it was not a very good invention in practicality. Now, this seems to be an interesting idea that was poorly executed. I can think of a few people, Mom, who could use a fifth wheel for parking, but I don't want to blow up their spot, Mom. Now, all this research got me thinking. Now, maybe I could come up with my own car invention. And in 100 years, when someone else is doing a roundup of failed car inventions on GlorpTube or whatever, maybe I'll be on that list. So I thought really long and hard about what problem I wanted to fix. And then one night, in the middle of the night, it hit me like a ton of bricks. And I got up out of my coffin and I wrote it down in a notebook, all right? A lot of cars these days are, let's say, ugly. We can't have angular front ends. We aren't allowed to have pop-up up and down headlights. And why is that? It's because of pedestrian safety regulations, okay? But let me ask you this. What are pedestrians doing for car safety? Nothing. Until now. Allow me to introduce to you the Pumphrey Pedestrian Accident Safety Suit. By wearing this revolutionary safety suit at all times when outside of the house and not in a car, I predict that fatalities in pedestrian traffic incidents could fall as low as 0%. Problem solved. Pop-up up and down headlights are back, baby. If you enjoyed this video and want to watch another video having to do with innovations in the car industry, check out this episode of my best friend Nolan's show, Wheelhouse. Thank you guys so much for watching D-List and everything else on Donut Media. If this is your first video, welcome aboard. It's a very nice place to be. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and like that like bell. We got a new video every day. I love you.